curriculum is also important cell organelle, which is one of the most important cell organelle. And what is the function of media? Endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum helps in the transport of the substances from one cell to the another cell. Endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. Endoplasmic reticulum which have granules on their surface, we call those granules as ribosomes. Those we say as rough endoplasmic reticulum, which will not have granules on their surface, we call as a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, it will manufacture the substances and transport the substances from one cell to the another cell whenever it is required. That is about endoplasmic reticulum. In today's video, we will learn about the structure of the nucleus. This is the structure of the nucleus and the important parts which are present in the nucleus. A thread-like structure is there, and this thread-like structure we call as a genetical material. Through this genetical material only the whatever the genetical information is there from the parents, it will be transferred to their offspring. And here a round door-like structure is there, and this we call as a nucleolus. And here we call this as a nuclear core. And the outer membrane is there, and this we call as a nuclear membrane. Just like it is a cell membrane, which is present in the plant cell and the animal cell. What cell membrane will do? It gives the production to the entire cell. Now it not only giving the production, it helps in the transport of the substances and just like it only the nuclear membrane also giving the production to the entire nucleus, and it was named by Robert Brown in the year 1831. Nucleus was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. Cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke in the year 1665, whereas the nucleus was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. And it is one of the most important cell organelle, and compared to all the cell organelles, nucleus is the largest cell organelle. It gives the mitochondria, nucleus, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, cell membrane. Compared to all these, nucleus is the largest and important cell organelle. And it was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. And nucleus regulates and controls the function of the cell and determines the characteristics of the organism. And that's why we call nucleus as a cell's control room. We have labeled nucleus as a cell's control room. And it consists of genetical material information also. This is what thread-like structures are there. This is what called genetical materials. And through this genetical materials, whatever the genes which are present in the parent, those same genes will be transferred to their offspring. And based on the presence and absence of the nucleus, cells are of two types. They are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. And now we see about the prokaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, nuclear membrane around the nucleus is absent. This is what called the nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane will be absent in the prokaryotic cells. And most prokaryotic cells are unicellular organisms only. And here it consists of single chromosome only. Like this, many number of chromosomes will be not there in prokaryotic cells. Only a single chromosome will be present in prokaryotic cells. Nucleolus is absent. Here a dot-like round-like structure is there. Now this dot-like round-like structure we call as a nucleolus. This nucleolus is absent in prokaryotic cell. And prokaryotic cells are smaller in size when comparing to the eukaryotic cell. And it is mostly found in the bacteria and blue-green algae. Prokaryotic cells are mostly they are found in bacteria and blue-green algae. Next, coming to the prokaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, nucleus is present in that. Mostly prokaryotic cells are multicellular organisms which they are present in human beings, plants, etc. And next, here it contains genetical material is present in the eukaryotic cells, and its size is compared to the prokaryotic cells. Larger in size. And now coming that nucleolus is, yes, this is what we call as a nucleolus. Nucleolus is present in eukaryotic cell. Nucleolus is absent in prokaryotic cells. Size is larger in eukaryotic cells. Size is smaller in prokaryotic cells. Nuclear membrane is present in eukaryotic cells. Nuclear membrane is absent in prokaryotic cells. This is about the structure of the nucleus and its function, and it was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. Based on the presence and absence of the nucleus, there are two kinds, there are prokaryotic cells and the eukaryotic cells. And today you write down and you draw the picture of the nucleus and label the parts and write down the function of the nucleus. selected home. Today's video will discuss about the nucleus. In before video I told you about the endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is the most important cell organelle. It is one of the most important cell organelle. And what is the function of media? Endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum helps in the transport of the substances from one cell to the another cell. Endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. Endoplasmic reticulum which have granules on their surface. All those granules as ribosomes. Those we say as rough endoplasmic reticulum, which will not have granules on the surface, is called as a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, it will manufacture the substances and transport the substances from one cell to the another cell whenever it is required. That is about endoplasmic reticulum. And today's video we will learn about the structure of the nucleus. This is the structure of the nucleus and the important important parts which are present in the nucleus. A thread-like structure is there. Now this thread-like structure called as a genetical material. Through this genetical material only the chromosome, whatever the genetical information is there from the parents, it will be transferred to their offspring. And here a round dot like structure is there, this we call as a nucleolus. And here we call this as a nuclear core. And the outer membrane is there, this we call as a nuclear membrane, just like it is a cell membrane which is present in the plant cell and the animal cell. What cell membrane will do? It acts, it gives the production to the entire. Not only giving the production, it helps in the transport of the substances from and just like it only the nuclear membrane also giving the production to the entire nucleus. And it was named by Robert Brown in the year 1831. Nucleus was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. Cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke in the year 1665. And whereas the nucleus was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. And it is one of the most important cell organelle. And compared to all the cell organelles, nucleus is the largest cell organelle. If you see mitochondria, nucleus, Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, cell membrane, comparing to all these, nucleus is the largest and important cell organelle. And it was named by the Robert Brown in the year 1831. And nucleus regulates and controls the function of the cell and determines the characteristics of the organism. And that's why we call nucleus as a cell's control room. Here we have labeled nucleus as a cell's control room. And it consists of genetical material information also. This is what thread-like structures are there. This is what called genetical materials. And through this genetical materials, whatever the genes which are present in the parent, those same genes will be transferred to their offspring. And based on the presence and absence of the nucleus, cells are of two types. They are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. And now we see about the prokaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, nuclear membrane around the nucleus is absent. This is what called the nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane will be absent in the prokaryotic cells. And most prokaryotic cells are unicellular organisms only. And here it consists of single chromosome only. Like this, many number of chromosomes will be not there in prokaryotic cells. Only a single chromosome will be present in prokaryotic cells. Nucleolus is absent. Here a dot-like round-like structure is there. Now this dot-like round-like structure we call as a nucleolus. This nucleolus is absent in prokaryotic cell. And prokaryotic cells are smaller in size when comparing to the eukaryotic cell. And it is mostly found in the bacteria and blue-green algae. Prokaryotic cells are mostly they are found in bacteria and blue-green algae. Next, coming to the prokaryotic cells. In prokaryotic cells, nucleus is present. Nucleus is present in that. Mostly prokaryotic cells are multicellular organisms which are present in human beings, plants, and next here it contains genetical material is present in the eukaryotic cells and its size is comparing to the prokaryotic cells. Eukaryotic cells are larger in size. And not only that, nucleolus is, yes, this is what we call as a nucleolus. Nucleolus is present in eukaryotic cell. Nucleolus is absent in prokaryotic cells. Size is larger in eukaryotic cells. Size is smaller in prokaryotic cells. Nuclear membrane is present in eukaryotic cells. Nuclear membrane is absent in prokaryotic cells. This is about the structure of the nucleus and its function.